Good afternoon. I'm Nita Farmer with the Washington County Chamber of Commerce, and we're so happy to have you here. Last new knowledge workshop for the year, and we're so happy to have Gina Patrick with Appalachian Sustainability.
Software that Adobe offers as part of that $49.99 package suite.
You get 1 terabyte of cloud-based storage with that subscription. We have another cloud-based server that we use, so I don't really utilize that storage space that much. But if you don't have a server, if you're a small business or small nonprofit and don't have a server in-house or a cloud-based server, this would be a really good way to kill 2 birds with 1 stone because you get accessibility to the software as well as storage capacity. So the first part of the document that I shared with you today is how to install Adobe or Acrobat. Once you create your account, you'll come to a screen like this. And under this desktop downloads, that's where it shows you all the suite of different softwares that you are eligible to get. You'll notice some say buy now and some say download, but for the most part, they're all included. There's a few that are extra. So you would go to, once you've created your account and got your subscription, you would go to download right here at Acrobat Pro. And it would bring you to another, I'm not going to do it because I already have it installed on my computer, but it would just prompt, it would pull up a screen and prompt you to install and run. And then once it's in there, it'll put a desktop shortcut on your computer. So I'll start with converting a document to PDF. This is really easy to do once you get it installed. You can, in Word, you can also do Save As or Save As the WPDF. It depends on which Word you have, I think, but that's a new option that they give you now. Or you can also go into Acrobat and save it as a Word document, but we'll start here. So it's really easy. You just say, save it as a PDF. I'll do that, and then we'll convert it back to Word. So there it is as the PDF. Then if you go to File, you can do Export To, and you can make them, like if you have an Excel spreadsheet, you can, you know, go back and forth between PDF and Excel or PowerPoint or image. No, I don't want spreadsheet, sorry. A lot of things won't convert really clean. It depends on the kind of document you have. This is just basically text, so it's not going to have any issues converting back and forth from PDF to Word. If you had something that was kind of grainy, that had been maybe scanned from a copier, it may misconstrue some of the words or letters and not be quite as clean. If you have things with signatures and logos, a lot of times those won't convert back and forth. It's getting better, I feel like. A lot of times before, like, no logo, I mean, just forget it. It was not going in there. But if it's not like a really complex logo now, usually it'll just plop it in there as an image for you. And then I wanted to show you how to do an image too, because a lot of people, especially now with Facebook, because you can't put a PDF on Facebook, it has to be an image. With our staff, they were struggling with putting stuff on Facebook, so I was constantly converting things like flyers or whatever to images. And so you would just do the same thing, but you export to an image in JPEG. And there's the different file types. I usually just always use JPEG, especially for Facebook. If you were going to put kind of a more high-resolution document together and you needed it as a bigger image, you would use maybe a TIFF for print or things like that. It should be there. There it is. And a lot of times, like if you are trying to make it an image and it's several pages, it will make each page an image. As you can see that it's done here, I have several pages. And you can then combine all of those into one PDF. I can show you how to do that now, actually. This is a very useful tool. If you have, like, when we're working on grants, a lot of times we have multiple letters of support, but they need to be one attachment. Well, when you scan them, like I said, you lose your quality a lot of times. So if everyone has sent them to me in a nice clean PDF, I would choose to combine them within PDF instead of just putting them in the scanner, and you risk them, you know, being grainy, being crooked, being upside down, or whatever. So if you go to Open and Create, you can say Combine Files into a Single PDF. And here it just asks you to drag and drop. Go find your files. I'll just put a couple together. And you can even choose like a Word document. And so if you had a Word document and you had a couple of PDFs and you had an Excel spreadsheet and you had an image, you could choose all those different types right in here and just combine. And then if it's a Word document or it's an image or an Excel spreadsheet, it will go ahead and convert it to PDF for you. So you don't have to do that separately. It's a lot quicker if they're all already PDFs, but it doesn't matter. And then it should prompt you to save it. It'll pull it up. So there's my three documents. And now I have them all in one place. That's my son's essay. So then you can put them all together. Alrighty. Any questions so far? Within Adobe, you also can edit PDFs, which is a new feature that's really cool, because before PDFs were just uneditable. So now if you go to Edit PDF, it'll put everything in a little box in here for you. This is especially helpful if you're using like a Google Doc or something that multiple people are editing. And it's got the capability to move things around a lot more easily. Like I said before, if you try to convert some really complex documents, the images and whatnot, into Word, it wouldn't be clean. Once you get in Word, your image may be up here and it's supposed to be beside your text. So the good thing is it kind of locks everything in its own little place. And then you can just go in there and change your text or make things smaller or bigger or move them around. And more these days, people are using the e-sign function of PDF. If you click on, I think it's this one. They just updated this, so it's a little bit different than what I'm used to seeing. Home. There we go. No tools. No. Home.
Where do I go? Yeah, it's under tools.
It is under tools.
Putting in the signatures?
Yes.
It's under tools.
There it is. Fill and sign. And so our executive director's out a lot. So I usually, I have like an image of her signature. So when I go in here, I can actually insert an image of her signature. And it's just like she signed it. But you also can use the sign function and actually like draw your signature if you're good at that. I am not. And then once you sign it, then you can send it right from here and you can track who else has signed it. Send it within this to other people to sign. And invite them to sign it. And so then once you do that, you have this PDF that, you know, you've not had to actually toss back and forth. It's all stayed right in one place. It makes it very clean. And you can add your information. We do a lot of grant submissions, so that's especially important for us because we can go in and put in, you know, it, sometimes these fillable forms, they want your DUNS number or your tax ID number and your address and all that stuff right there in one place. So before we would actually have to print the document, fill it all in, or try to convert the document to fill it in. So this is a really nice feature that PDF or Adobe has added. One thing is there's Adobe Acrobat Pro DC, which obviously reads, writes, edits, and does everything. If you have a lot of people in your business and you don't want to bump up to having more than 3 subscribers, I would recommend using your just regular Adobe Reader for your reader. Because if there are multiple people that are using this as the default, it's going to prompt you to sign people out over and over and over just to open a document. So that's a little problem we've had because I've actually been in here editing a document and someone just needed to read something and it bumped me out. So just a little something to think about. With so many of us, we'll probably have to bite the bullet and go to a higher subscription level, but for now, we're trying to save money. All right, Zoom, have any questions so far? Is there anything else within Adobe that I could show you that is not converting or editing or saving? I will say that it's also good when you edit documents in here. You can do, it's kind of like track changes. You can do comments and things like that are really helpful to use when you're editing documents back and forth. Some of the other features, you know, you can protect it and password protect it so that people can't change the whole thing, or you can only have certain sections that they can change. When you're working on grant documents, that's pretty important too, or any other business document that you wouldn't want someone to be able to just go in and, you know, change certain information. So like I had showed you before, when it puts everything in its own little box, you can either protect that little box or the whole document. And so you would just click on that box and hit protect, and then if you want the whole thing protected, it'll prompt you to just check it. Something else that's really cool is you can organize your pages within here. It's kind of like PowerPoint. You can move things around. You know, if you want to, you decide this one should be over here, that's really easy to do. Instead of copying and pasting all that, going up, creating a blank page, you know, like you have to do in Word a lot. So it gives you a lot more functionality to move things around or delete them. Or insert them. And then I think if you use Acrobat Pro, this Premiere Pro, the only difference in that is it's for videos. and not documents. I have not used that yet personally, but we did have someone on our staff that used it briefly when he was making videos for us. But I think that there's a lot of these different suite products that you could really benefit from in addition to, I don't know what some of these are. I know that Photoshop is really good for editing images. It's not extremely user-friendly, but there's a lot of great tutorials on there. If you just need to resize an image, it's really helpful. And then Lightroom is a new one that someone else just told me about, that you can share photos and, you know, keep them all together, and it's a lot more user-friendly, I believe, than Adobe Photoshop, so I'm going to check into Lightroom. She said she uses it for all of her photo editing. So I'm excited to check that one out. All right, I kind of flew through that. Does anyone have any questions? No? Okay. Was it helpful at all? Yeah. Alrighty, I don't really have anything else. That was about it. Sorry, that was pretty short. I thought it would take me longer. Our staff. There's actually an app. It's all app-based, so you can create a document from your phone with this app. You would just go to the app store and download it, and then you could take a image of your document and then convert it within the app on your phone.
I might have missed this, but did you say you used InDesign?
Some, yes.
Like for your newsletter?
No, we use Publisher right now for our newsletters. I do want to get my skills where I can create our newsletter and our annual report and things in InDesign. I'm just not there skill level wise yet. But I love to like watch tutorials and things. And once you learn InDesign and Photoshop, they're like really similar. And I've taken classes on both of those. But to get the design skills to where you can create like a multiple page document within those, I'm not there yet, but I hope to get there.
Do you use a lot of Photoshop?
Yes, I use Photoshop a lot, especially editing images like for our website. And we also put together a local food directory, and a lot of people will send us at their ads and they'll be the wrong size or whatever. So that it's really beneficial and easy to just...
It's a great directory too.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, that comes in really handy. Also, if you get, you know, like a graphic that's, you know, not the best quality, it's really easy to clean up in Photoshop.
Have you ever used Illustrator?
I have not. I kind of download, try to play around with it, but no, I have not used Illustrator.
When you talk about the suite that your organization, I guess, that you buy, mm-hmm. the subscription and everything, is that for all of those products that you
yes.
can use?
It is. You know, like, so... We pay $50 a month for 3 users, and I could go in here and download any of these and have unlimited access to them, along with the 1 terabyte of storage for $50 a month. And so that's really great, because if you were even just to go purchase Photoshop, even through TechSoup is expensive, which, by the way, TechSoup is a great place to get software if you're a nonprofit, donated. But you know, some of the, if you went to get all these, it'd be thousands of dollars worth of software. So paying for that subscription, and you know, if you don't need it tomorrow, you can just cancel it, or you know, just not use it.
Do they have a special rate for nonprofits within this?
That's what that rate is, I believe. I'm pretty sure that was a discounted rate for nonprofits.
I know one thing that, we have, like, we do a lot of work for the Industrial Development. And a lot of times we get documents in the PDFs. Do you know of anything that will convert them back to Word?
Yeah, this will do it.
It will do that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you get, say you get a document like, I'll do this one for, this will be a good example. So this is a huge document that, as you can see, has lots of images and lots of text. If I needed to extract something from this, I could try to export it to Word, and I'll show you what it does. Okay, so now it's a Word document, which you can see, it did pull over some of the images and things. There might be a few things in here that didn't convert cleanly. It looks like it actually did a pretty good job. But, it did keep some of the formatting, the colors and things like that. I had one document one time that I converted, and for whatever reason, it turned every I in the document into an L. And so it was showing all these words that were misspelled. So,
it's font-based, depending on what font it's formatted into, and if you have that font, depending on what little word you have, it'll be.
And sometimes it gets a little wonky with spacing too, if you have something that's kind of really chunky. I can't believe it actually did that great. But you could, so once you convert it into Word or Excel or whatever, then you can just save it, and then you can put it right back into PDF and send it back or whatever. We had one document one time that there was like one little image in the center. I guess it was a logo. And for whatever reason, it would put a big black circle right in the middle. It was just a big black circle. It just would not convert over. But so every time we were working on that document, we'd have to take out the big black circle and put back in the logo. But for the most part, it does a really good job. And it saves a ton of time. It makes you so much more efficient when you can, have the capability to go back and forth between document types. It can. It helps some things, but again, not all. But it is very useful. What it does, I believe, is makes the document like a higher resolution, like better quality. To try to protect some of those things from getting loosey-goosey. Alrighty. Any more questions?
Gina?
Yes?
Thank you for being here today.
You're welcome.
We were talking earlier that you are coming back to do some other presentations.
So, next is, where did we see it?
Let's see.
Oh, okay, so April 18th, we'll be doing Constant Contact and PictoChart. Constant Contact is an email marketing platform, and PictoChart is something you can create, like flyers, fun to work with. And then we will be doing grants, how to find and apply for grants on May the 20th. And with that one, I wanted to show you Grant Hub, which is a grant management software, but you can also use it for other things besides grants. And then how to search for grants with Grant Watch and Grant Station.
We're going to keep you busy next year.
I'm excited. It's fun.
Well,
thanks
thank
for
you.
Having me.
Really appreciate you being here. Any other?
Social media marketing.
So, also wanted to remind everybody, if you know someone that has a existing business or just starting a business, we're doing our 5th annual Washington County Business Challenge competition. The deadline to register is January the 8th, and then we'll start the classes January the 23rd and run through February the 27th. So if you have any questions, please give us a call. You can pick up the information at the chamber here at the incubator. And as always, you're here, and that's why we're here. So So, thank you and Merry Christmas.